Good afternoon. Today we'll be having a discussion about an experiment, how to design adder, integrator and differentiator using operational amplifier, and we are verifying the circuit performance. Okay, before going to that, just I want to ask you a question. What are the capacitors you used in your ED lab? Have you come across with the capacitors? Yeah, what are the capacitors whether you used? Okay, value, do you remember?
475.
Okay, 475.
Micro, 470 micro.
470 microfarad you used. Any other capacitors? Okay, fine. Just want to convey you that how to recognize a capacitor, that is ceramic capacitors. Then I'll take up with the experiment, that is adder integrator. We'll take up one by one. So this is the ceramic capacitors. So you're going to use this type of capacitors now in the AC lab. So you can observe the number 100, 101, 102, 103, 104. So here you're going to identify whether it is a 0.1 or a 0.01 microfarad. So the actual logic is the first two digits indicate the number, that is, let me show for 104. So 10 into the third number is exponential, that is 10 into 10 power 4. Okay, so that is picofarad, it is actually. So pico means how much? 10 power?
Minus 2.
Yeah, can you able to read the slide? Can you able to read the slide?
Yes.
Yeah. Into 10 power minus 12. So how much you'll get now?
10 power minus
10 into 10 power minus 8. Okay. So if I want to make it this micro, what will be the value? Or I can write this as 1 into 10 power minus 7. Okay. It is 1 into 10 power minus 7 microfarad, or I can make this as 0.1 into 10 power minus 6. Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So now I can say it is a 0.1, 10 power minus 6 means is micro, 0.1 microfarad. So labelly you will get a capacitor like this. So you need to identify whether it is a 0.1 or 0.01 or 0.001 based on your requirement. This number should be, you should know the number. Okay, make a note of that, all of you. 104 means 0.1. Like this only you have to do it. You need to convert it into micro. Okay, the conversion will be, you need to divide it by 1000, nano to micro 1000, or pico to nano also 1000 you need to divide. Is this clear now? So first two digits indicate the number, the third digit is an exponential power. All these capacitors are in picofarad. So if you want to convert that into micro, this is the procedure. So 104 means 0.1 microfarad, 103 0.01, 102 0.001, 101 point followed by 0001, and 100 is point followed by 401 microfarad. So according to my knowledge, you will be using in your lab 102, 103, 104. Okay. So this is about ceramic capacitor values and codes. aim of this experiment is to need to design adder, integrator and differentiator using operational amplifier. Okay, first let me take up with an adder. So I hope we have studied in the module 4, that is inverting amplifiers. So in that we have come across with inverting adder, adder circuit. So addition can be done in inverting and non-inverting configuration. So here we are going to have an inverting adder. So if you want to design an adder, here this is a circuit. What you are going to do in practically, so here it is, is it, I hope I can identify the two inputs V1 and V2 are applied to the inverting terminal. So that's why it is an inverting adder. So output you are going to get in a negative inverted output. Am I correct?
Yes.
So we are adding two input signals, that is V1 and V2. And here this is, why you want to use this resistor? Can anyone tell me? Because positive terminal has to be grounded, but we have not grounded, we have used one resistor. What do you call for this resistor? Yes. Can you recall from the module 4? In order to make a voltage drop across inverting and non-inverting, we'll be using a compensating resistor. Or with what is the prefix we have used? Compensating resistor. In DC and AC amplifier, I told you the resistor is connected to the positive terminal. What is the value of R3 now? R3 value will be R1, R2 in what fashion? And RF?
RF.
Yes. So whatever the voltage drop across this inverting terminal, or I can say the resistors, what you have connected. So this will be, the same voltage drop has to be happen in the non-inverting terminal also, to offset, or I can say to nullify the offset. We are going to use this resistor. So as I told you, that IC741 has a offset nulling technique, or I can use this external resistor here. Okay, so this is about a circuit we are using here, V1 and V2. So can you tell me now what are the components you require to design the circuit? So our intention is to measure the output voltage using voltmeter. Yes, you require an operational amplifier, resistors, then what else?
Voltage.
Voltage supplier. How many supply you required here?
Two.
Two supply you required. That is V1 and V2. Two power supplies you need to use here to provide two different voltages. And then you required operational amplifier supply. 12 volts or 15 volts, plus or minus 12 or plus or minus 15 volts. So two types of power supply here. Open supply separately and voltage regulated DC supply. And resistors. And voltmeter is going to be used and measure across pin number 6. So we need to note down the output voltage by providing different V1, V2 values. So can anyone tell me the expression for Vout for inverting adder? Or summing, both are same. Vout is equal to, what is the expression? RF by?
Minus.
Yeah, minus
RF by RD.
RF by
R1
into V1. Okay, whole into, right?
Yes.
Next.
RF by R2 into V2.
RF by R2 into V2. That's it. Yes. So what we have studied in the theoretical, we have assumed R1, R2, RF are equal. Then it will be minus of V1 plus V2. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
So in this case, it is not like that. So we have chosen R1 1.8, R2 1.2K, 18K. So here, the from as I told you in the introduction of operational amplifiers, 741. So it has its own meaning. There are 8 pins in your IC. One is not using. 8 pin is no use. Among a 7 pin, the 4 are the inputs, 2 input and 2 supply and 1 output. Okay. So resistors, we required 4 resistors, 1.2, 1.8 and 18K capacitor. Not for this capacitor, it is for differentiator and integrator. Okay. 2 variable power supply. So what we are using in the lab is regulated supply, range is 0 to 30 volts. You require 2, one for V1 and other for V2, 2 inputs, okay? And op amp power supply, plus or minus 15 volts or plus or minus 12 volts. And you require a voltmeter to measure the output voltage. Okay, this signal generator CRO and capacitor is for differentiator and integrator, okay? So here you have to note down what is V1, what we are going to give V1 and V2, and here the expression what you are told is correct, RF by R1 into V1 plus RF by R2 into V2. The formula is this. So if you substitute the value, so RF is 18K, and R1 is 1.8, R2 is 1.2. So R1 is 1.8K, R2 is 1.2. Okay, now substitute into this expression. So what you are going to get, 18 by 1.8. How much? 18 by 1.8. That is minus of 10. 1.8 by 80 is how much it is? 18 by 1.8K. Yes. Just substitute into this, substitute the resistor values. So you're going to get 10V1 plus 15V2. So 18K by 1.2 will be 15. So 15 times V2. Okay. So I have here given the values V1, V2 are in terms of 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, like that. So you'll get it, you'll get confused that, or you'll get a doubt that saying why can't you take V1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 5, 6 volts. So what will happen if you take V1 as 2 volts? V1, 2 volts, V2, 3 volts. Tell me what is the value you're going to get. Substitute 10V1 plus 15V2. Yes.
Minus 4.
So minus 4. Okay. So here we have to assume the values are 0.1 and 0.2. So what is the value you are going to get if you substitute?
Minus 4.
So theoretical value is minus 4. So you're going to get approximately around 4 you're going to get. You're not getting exactly 4 because due to offset variations or voltage variations, you'll be getting approximately 4. That is 3.96 or 3.98. So you have to measure the output across pin number 6. That is in op amp. The 6th pin is dedicated for output, so you can observe here. So 4 and 7 at the supply, 2 is inverting, 3 is non-inverting, 6 pin number 6 is output. So when you measure a multimeter, if you keep a positive terminal of multimeter across 6 and the negative black color at the negative ground, so you're going to get a voltage around 4 volts. So next, what will be the value you're going to get when you substitute V1 as 0.3 and V2 as 0.2? Again, minus of it is 6 volts. Yeah. So you are going to measure practically with the multimeter, okay? So voltmeter and multimeter, you are going to measure the practical value of an adder. So instead of 0.1 and 0.2, if I take 1 and 2, so 10 plus 30, how much? For example, if you substitute V1 1 volt, V2 2 volts. So how much you are going to get? Is minus 40 volts. So always your output should not exceed the supply, whatever the supply range what you are using is plus or minus input kodtirada supply voltage plus or minus 15 or plus or minus 12, and it is having its own specification. Output voltage should not exceed that, so that's why we are not choosing 1 volt or 2 volts. We'll be taking within 1, that is 0.1, 0.2, like this. Okay, is this clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now how much for 0.2 and 0.4? If you substitute 0.2 and 0.4, how much value you are going to get? 10 into 0.2 plus 15 into 0.4. It is minus 8 volts. Similarly here, minus
5.5.
Yeah. What about minus last one? 10. It is minus 10. So all are within your plus or minus 15 volts. Okay. Is this clear now with the adders?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, this is the one you need to do in the lab. So practical. You need to measure across pin number 6 by providing the value V1 and V2. So by using two different power supply, you need to set this value by using a multimeter. So many voltage novel tune maadi 0.1 bantu andre, it is not accurate. You need to measure with multimeter from the supply. So supply multimeter 0.1 set maadbeku. Regulated DC supply alli eshtadru barli, is multimeter you need to follow. Okay. So next move on to the differentiator. So the differentiator is used to have your output will be a differentiate of input signal. So here output waveform will be the derivative of input waveform. We are going to use here basic, is it an inverting or non-inverting amplifier? What type of circuit is this? Giving input to the negative terminal and positive is grounded. Is it inverting or non-inverting amplifier?
Non-inverting.
Inverting or non-inverting amplifier? Basic.
What?
Basic inverting amplifier, because you're giving input to the inverting terminal and non-inverting is grounded here. So if an input resistor, so just a basic inverting amplifier, what you are having, so you are having here a resistor R1, so that R1 is replaced by a capacitor C. Okay, so if you compare to the basic inverting amplifier, this is the changes. R1 RF is a feedback resistor you had in inverting amplifier. Simply you have to replace R1 by a capacitor. So now V0 is equal to, you're going to have RF into C times the negative instantaneous rate of change of input voltage, V in with respect to time. Okay, so first let me go with analysis. So here if you apply a KCL, so I in is entering to the node and IF is leaving away from the node. So I in minus IF is equal to 0, R I in is equal to IF. IF will be based on the current direction. So you have, due to virtual concept, you have 0 here. 0 minus V out. So 0 minus V out will be minus V out by RF. So minus V out by RF. Because the resistor is connected to the two potential, one is 0 due to this virtual ground concept, and this is connected to V out. So 0 minus V out by the resistance, that is nothing but your current. So as you know that capacitor's charge will be Q is equal to CV. CV is input voltage. Okay. So if you differentiate with respect to time, dQ by dt is equal to C times dV in by V dt. So this is also the charge, capacitor charge is nothing but your input current. Yes or no? Because capacitor is connected towards the input side. So whatever the charge stored in the capacitor is nothing but your input current. So Iin is equal to C into dV in by dt, that is also equal to IF. So if you substitute the IF here, minus V out by RF. So if you manipulate, so you're going to get V out is equal to minus RF into C dV in by dt. Yes. Is this clear with an expression? So you're going to get V out will be negative times RFC, the instantaneous rate of change of input voltage. So that is dV in by dt. Yes, all of you copied.
Yes, ma'am.
Shall we continue? Yes, reply.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. So, what is the circuit? What you have observed here, this could not be used in practical implementation. This is not enough. So, sometimes we are using this as an amplifier, and many of the times we'll be using for the wave shaping circuits. So, somewhere you will be going to use in the wave shaping circuits, input sine wave you are giving, but you will be expecting cosine waveform, or sometimes you will be giving triangle waveform, you are expecting square wave. So like this wave shaping circuits, you can usually find the applications of integrator and differentiators, okay? And moreover, if you use this actual inverting basic circuit, so you'll get some distortions. So here we need to use some additional resistors and capacitors in the feedback side and as well as the input side. And also you need to equate the voltage drop across both the terminals, whether it's positive and negative. That should be taken care when using a practical implementation. So what will be the drawback of single resistor and capacitor? For example, if you want to use this circuit for practical implementation, that is by using a single capacitor and single resistor, the drawback will be, as you know that the gain of the circuit is based on the RC constant. So that is RF by or the capacitance, that is XC1, is going to be increases with increase in frequency. So at a rate of 20 dB per decade. So what it will happen, this make circuit will be unstable. So we are restricted to the gain will be 20 dB per decade. So that is input impedance XC is going to be decreases. You can observe in this expression. Frequency and the impedance XC are inversely proportional. So if frequency increases, your XC is going to be decreases. So then it makes a circuit very susceptible to the random noise signals, and any noise or harmonics present in the source circuit will be amplified more than the input signal. Noise may amplify more than the input signal. That's why you have to take care of this capacitance value, or I can say input impedance XC. So ZI input impedance can also be written as XC. As you all know that XC is equal to 1 by 2 times pi FC. Okay, so this will be the drawback of if you use a single capacitor and single resistor. The first thing is the gain will be at 20 dB per decade. This makes circuit unstable, and input impedance is going to be decreases with increase in frequency. Again, it will make susceptible to random noise signals. Moreover, your amplifier, it will amplify only the noise signals, not than the input signal. Okay, you'll get the discarded output, not a valid output. Shall I continue? Yes. So this is your studied in your basic electronics. Okay. So basic circuit is this, but you are not implementing this circuit. I hope you got the drawback of this single resistor and capacitor. Shall I go to the next slide? Okay, this is a practical implementation of differentiator. So by using these additional resistor and capacitors, we can achieve a stability, good stability, and high frequency noise problems will be corrected. So that is, you can observe actual circuit as with one resistor and capacitor. So this is the circuit we have used, basic circuit, or what you have come across in the previous slide. Okay, so this positive is grounded, so you are going to give input to the non-inverting terminal through the capacitor, and you have a feedback resistor. Okay, so this is RF. So now you have observed this is additional resistor used and additional capacitor CF is used here. And this is a, I hope, a compensating resistor. Okay. So here you can observe, if you give an input, here you are going to use the signal generator to provide the input. So the input will be in the signal generator, you can give a different waveforms. It may be sinusoidal, it may be square, it may be triangle. So you can give that. So if you give an input set it to a triangular waveform, you are going to get a waveform expected in a differentiation is square wave output. If you give a sine wave, you are going to get output as cosine. If you give a cosine wave, you will get a sine wave. Okay, derivation, differentiation of input signal. Okay. Yes, is this clear?
It's magic.
So here no need of noting down anything, but you need to observe carefully that if you give triangle, are you getting a square wave? So you need to set a frequency in a such a way that for what frequency you're going to get exact square wave if you give an input as a triangular wave. So here you required a components op amp supply, and then you require a signal generator to give an input sinusoidal signals, or it may be triangle. AC signal has to be given here, and you are going to measure output with the CRO across pin number 6. Okay. So here, this condition should be, remember, T should be greater than or equal to RF into Cin. Okay. Whatever the frequency is, time constant, depends on the time constant, RC time constants itself. Yes? Yes, shall we continue?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Again, what will happen if you add the input resistor? So, if you add an input resistor across in series with the capacitor, it is going to limit the differentiators. It is going to be increasing gain of the ratio RF by R1. Gain is going to be increased, and this Rn is going to limit that gain. Then additional attenuation of higher frequencies is going to be accomplished by capacitor CF in parallel with a differentiator feedback resistor RF. So we added R1 and CF, right? So R1 is to limits the gain and CF is to have attenuation of higher frequencies. That is additional attenuation. These are the waveforms I can observe, and you are going to you have to draw this graph, waveforms in the graph sheet. So that's why you need to measure the frequency and the amplitude, because the same thing you need to plot it in the graph sheet. Okay, so this is the input you're going to give for differentiator. Don't confuse with the integrator again. So you're going to get an output will be square wave. Okay. So if you give square wave, you're going to get a spikes. So these are the spikes we can get. So input is square, output will be the spikes. If you give input as sinusoidal, you're going to get output will be the cosine. So you can observe it is starting point here, and this is start from origin. Okay, like this you need to observe the three different inputs and what will be the expected output waveforms. And you need to keep a condition that frequency has to be this, RT should be greater than or equal to RF into Cn. So based on this, you need to have a trial and error method to get an exact square wave. So this is also same again. Square means spikes, triangle means square, sine means. So which one is correct? Cosine. This one or previous one? Yes.
This one.
Okay, you can observe when you're doing practically. So output signal will be changed, and whose final shape is also dependent upon this RC time constant. Okay, after resistor capacitor combination, how you are going to connect this RC components. So as I told you, it is mainly used in the wave shaping circuits. Like it is like a filter sometimes, not exactly filter. It can amplify both high frequency and low frequency. I can't say exactly it is filter, but it is like it is used for the wave shaping circuits. So these are the applications. So this circuit, wave shaping circuits to detect high frequency component in an input signal, and it is using FM modulators, rate of change detector. Next, coming to the integrator, so again it is like a basic inverting amplifier circuit. RF is replaced with a capacitor. So previous case, input R1 is replaced with a capacitor, and we have used a feedback resistor. Here it is reverse of it. Input is resistance and feedback you have a capacitor. So if you analyze by applying KCL, you are going to get an expression is Vout is equal to 1 by minus of 1 by RC integration of 0 to T V in into dt. So that is also equal to, it is, I can say output is an integration of input voltage V in into dt. Okay, so output voltage will be proportional to integral of input voltage. So again, here also the same issues we are going to find a facing, that is with a single resistor and capacitor. Again, that is also an article, not a practical use. So practical implementation this. So compared to previous circuit, we have used a resistor and we have used a capacitor here. Resistors, additional resistor RF is used. Again, here also we need to have a stability and high frequency. Okay. So again, here also you are going to observe, you are going to give input signal as a square wave, and output you are expecting is a triangle, whereas in differentiator is the reverse of it. You are giving triangle, expected square wave. Okay, you should not confuse with that. If you give square, you will get a triangle waveform in integration. So this is the waveform. So if you give a square wave, you're going to get a triangular wave as output. Yes, any doubt? Next, coming to this same implication of op-amp differentiator and integrators, mainly it is used to design and operate on triangle and square wave, rectangular signals. So as I told you, it is differentiators are find applications in wave shaping circuits to detect high frequency components, and integrator circuits are mainly used in analog computers and A to D converters. As usual, wave shaping circuits. So analog computers and analog to digital converters are meant for, are used by using, this integrator will be used in these two most frequently, as well as the differentiator is used in wave shaping circuits. Yes, is this clear with this experiment? Yes. Any doubt? So first is you need to have adder. So this you need to note down what is the output voltage by this tabulation by providing these voltages. You need to match with your theoretical value, but you are not getting exactly the theoretical value. You will be getting approximately a value through that because of the supply variation or due to offset value. So you are not getting exactly. Okay, you will be getting around the expected value or a theoretical value. Then about differentiator, integrator. So we are not using with a single resistor and capacitors. So that leads to a distortion, and sometimes gain should not be a stable. So here the gain is depends on your RC time constant, and also you need to observe in differentiator and integrator what will be the expected output waveform by providing different input waveforms. So you're going to use a signal generator, going to give AC input. It may be a sinusoidal input, or it may be square, or it may be triangle. So you need to set a frequency in such a way that to get a expected output. Because if you give a triangle, you have to get a square in differentiator. But frequency should be taken, consider that the time constant, based on the time constant, the T should be greater than or equal to RC. Similarly, the waveforms, if you give square, you will get a spike. If you give sine, you will get a cosine. Integrator also, just a reverse of differentiation it is. Give square, we'll get a triangle waveform in integration. And these are the applications we have, what you have discussed. So try to answer these questions based on today's discussion. What is the answer for first one? So I told you the one, yes, as the frequency increases, what is the input impedance of differentiator? Input side alone connect my series.
Okay.
Yes, I told you a notation, right? Input impedance ZI is equal to XC. That is capacitor is going to connect at the differentiator input side. So xc, you know that it is 1 by 2 pi fc. Yes. So the input impedance, as the frequency increases, input impedance going to be decreases because these two are inversely proportional. So answer is decreases. What is the answer for second one? So which will be in the feedback path connection in inverting? Capacitor. Yeah, capacitor, correct. What are the important applications of differentiators? It is option?
Option C.
Option C. So it is used to detect high frequency components in the input signal. So next question. If you give square wave input to the differentiator, what will be the shape of output waveform?
Triangle.
Triangle.
Yes. Think and tell. So differentiator, if you give triangle, you'll get square. If you give square,
spikes, ma'am.
Yeah, spikes. So extra components are used for practical implementation of differentiator are? What are the extra components we added? Option A, option C.
Option A.
We added input resistor 1 and feedback capacitor. R1 and CF are added for the practical implementation. Then what are the important application of integrators?
All of the above.
It can be used in analog to digital converter, analog computers, wave shaping circuits, all of the above. Yes, all of you got at least some picture of how to do this experiment. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.